I think for this year is the Word of God. God's Word. We looked in Matthew chapter 4, beginning with verse 18, you'll find these words. And Jesus, walking by the Sea of Galilee, saw two brethren, Simon called Peter, and Andrew his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers. And he said unto them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. And they straightway left their nets and followed him. And going on from thence, he saw other two brethren, James the son of Zebedee, and John his brother, in a ship with Zebedee their father, mending their nets. And he called them. And they immediately left the ship and their father and followed him. Church, say amen.
Amen.
One of the things that as Christians, as believers, that we must accept, and then after accepting, be obedient to do, to follow, and that is the Word of God. It is imperative, it is crucial, because we live in a day and time where everybody seems to want to have their own sense of what's right and what's wrong.
Amen.
They'll say, well, that may not be right for you, but it's all right for me. Well, God's Word is our standard. And particularly for us as believers, the challenge for us today, and as we will see in the Word of God, is to allow God, through His Holy Word, to make us what He would have us to be. Scripture begins then with Jesus in the northern part of the country, Israel, in Galilee, and Scripture says that he saw two brothers, Simon and Peter, and Andrew his brother, casting a net. He tells them, follow me and I will make you fishers of men. He then sees two other brethren, James and John, mending their nets, and he calls them also. The work of the fisherman then, when we look at it, is physically demanding work. Be a fisherman. It is outdoor work. It is not in the office in air conditioned work. It's physically demanding work. You got to deal with the weather. It can be hot and it can be cold. Because they're out on the water, then they can be wet, and when you're wet and it's cold, that's a bad combination. But their business is fishing, so despite the circumstances, they still have to be good businessmen and keep their focus on the task.
All right.
Often they would fish at night. Luke chapter 5 tells us that there was an occasion when Jesus was talking to the disciples and they had been fishing all night and hadn't caught anything.
All right.
And Jesus gave them instruction to get back in the boat and go right back out to where they had been fishing all night. So now that sounds a bit strange, because many folk in the time of Jesus saw him as a carpenter's son. And so as such, they would think that he only might know about carpentry, but how can he know anything about fishing? Well, Jesus set all that in order, because he told them, get back in the boat, launch out into the deep, let down the nets. And the response from Peter said, oh, we toiled all night, but nevertheless, since you told us to do it, we go ahead and do it. And he only partially did it. He let down one of the nets. They had two boats, but he did like we do. He'll shortcut it sometimes. And we ought to be able to say amen to Peter. Amen. Lord, tell us to do this, and we'll shortcut it and say, well, I'll do this much, and then if I see that much work, then I'll do the rest later on.
Amen.
But to Peter's amazement when he let the one net down in the same place where they had been fishing and caught nothing. Now they caught an abundance of fish.
Amen.
And so now Jesus knows a little bit about fishing. So when he says here in the text, "I will make you fishers of men," he knows what he's talking about. Fishing is not only physically hard work, but it's also mentally taxing, because when you're doing it for business and not recreation, then it matters whether or not you catch something. Now, some of you recreational fishermen, if you go out and start fishing and if you catch something, it's all right, but if you don't, it's all right also, because you just was happy to be down there on the bank fishing. You know, it was just your leisure time, but that's leisure fishing. But when you fishing for business, now you got to catch something in order that you can have something to be able to put on the table at the end of the day. So fishing requires patience. To be a good fisherman, you have to have patience. And certainly, as we saw again in the Gospel of Luke 5, chapter 5, not only do you have to be patient, but you also have to deal with disappointment. Because there are times when you fish all night and not catch anything. But you can't be, and this was the message that Jesus was driving home to them in Luke 5. You can't be so disappointed at that failure that you stop trying.
Amen.
And church, that's a word to us today.
Amen.
Even in life, when some things just don't work out like we planned, we got up in the morning, we had a plan. It's not just like we were going through the day haphazard. We had our plan, but things just didn't seem to work out. Don't be so disappointed that if the Lord speaks to you and says, "Now go back, and here's what you do," that you don't hesitate, but immediately respond to the prompting of the Lord.
Yeah.
So here they were, two sets of brothers, out doing and applying their trade. Now the scripture says this, one set, Peter and his brother were casting a net, and then James and John were mending their nets. Very important, because as responsible fishermen, it just goes without saying that in order to catch the fish, you got to cast the net, right?
Amen.
I mean, that just makes sense. But at the end of the day, the Bible will show us that the other set of brothers, after having cast the net, they are mending the nets. Over in Luke again, Luke 5, it says that they were washing their nets.
All right, right.
These issues are critically important, because I said all of that to get to this point in the Word of God, and that is, when Jesus says that he will make them fishers of men, they know how to do some things in the natural. But Jesus wants to take what they know in the natural and now elevate it that it can be used in a spiritual application to be fishers of men. And therefore, let me center for the next moment or so on the casting and mending of the net. The casting of the net, initially we might look at it and say, well, that's spreading God's word, putting the net out, and God's word can be spread, and then it would be able to catch those that it will catch. And certainly that's an application, but let us challenge ourselves and let us allow the Holy Spirit to challenge us today from this perspective. When Jesus says, "I will make you fishers of men," that then the net becomes the word of God in the life of the believer. The word of God in the life of the believer. So that when it's casting the net, then it is literally putting the believer out there so that they can then be used of God to bring in to catch a fish.
Amen.
Here's why it's imperative that we not divorce or separate the casting from the fishermen themselves. There are a whole lot of folk that want to talk Bible. There are a whole lot of folk that want to quote scripture. And I submit to us today, God wants us to live the word in our lives so that when it comes to ministering to somebody that don't know the Lord, then you minister, you cast the net by the life that you live. And so it's not just tell somebody else what they ought to do. It ought to be here by the example of God in my life. That's what Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. You can't talk about church. You can't talk about Jesus and then live any kind of way every day of the week. Casting the net. There are a whole lot of unsaved folk that we come in contact with every day.
Yeah.
And if our lives were lived as the Word of God would have us to live for God, church would be surprised what the net can catch if we would just live it. Talk about Jesus, but then they're the first one cheating on the time clock. You can't be talking about how good God is, and you're late to work, and you're trying to sneak out early, and even when you're on the clock, you ain't doing the job. And your life speaks about the things that you say that you got. If you love the Lord, work.
Walk with them.
To not only watch, but to mend it. Because as a result of watching it, if you find that there has been a snag, it got caught on some piece of something, debris down in the sea, maybe a cliff or rock or something that it snagged. You want to be sure to mend it because you don't want to have a gaping hole in it that then could actually be missing what it was intended to bring in. Well, when Jesus says, I want to show you and make you fishers of men.
Yes, sir.
If the net then is our lives as we live it according to God's word, then what the scripture shows us is that it's important that even after we have been used by God, after God has ministered and brought others in as a result of the testimony of those who will be used of God, we then, when we get back to shore, need to be careful and wash and bend ourselves. What do you mean by that? Well, here's what I mean. It's important that start with the preacher. Start with the preacher. That we stay before God and ask the Lord that if there's anything that the Lord ain't satisfied with, clean me up. That once we have a minister and our ministry, that when we get back to shore, get into God's word and allow God's word to do some cleaning in us.
Amen.
And then when necessary, some mending in us. Because now don't nobody testify. I'm talking now. And y'all can just listen. If we're not careful, even some of us saved, sanctified, born again, Holy Ghost filled, and five baptized Christians, every now and then say some things we ought not say. I take cussing off the table. The act in your heart.
And if you think about it long enough, the enemy has a way of playing with your mind that makes you think you can do it and get away with it. Me bother with me. Now they got on halo that they pray.